Well, now let's discuss some, you know, some, you know, optimization, customization. There are lot many, not only restricted to these points, whatever we are discussing now. So let's get them through one by one. So depending on the need of this, so this managed table and hive managed table, this is not actually optimization technique. This is just like the general practice we can do. Okay, so depending on the requirement, you can go for managed or external table. So always remember that where clause gets evaluated before the join tables. Okay, so when we perform the join between two tables, and if we have where clause in that join, so where clause will be evaluated first. Okay, so it means that if that where clause filters out most of the records, so join will never happen. Okay, because you already have filter out on which the join may be performed. So whenever you write a join and include the where clause in it, just be sure that so write your query accordingly to avoid unwanted results. Because if you are expecting that the join will show some records to you, but then again in the where clause they will be filtered out, so the join will never happen. Create index on the fields on the table that frequently. So this indexing is a good thing. Sometimes in, I think, Cloudera, maybe you will see the indexing because it may allow. In Tej, it does not allow. So basically, in Hortonworks, you won't see indexing, but indexing is a good thing just to make your queries faster for the frequent queries that you are running in which you are using a particular column frequently. Okay, so on the top of it, if it is having lesser cardinality, that is lesser number of unique values, you can always create the index on the top of it. But then there is a cost associated when you want to create index and keep it updated for all the values those are there in that table for that particular column. Okay, so indexing is a good practice, but it comes with some cost. So while creating index on the field, just take the cardinality number of unique values. So we already discussed this. It should be lesser. The lesser the cardinality, the good will be the indexing. Always put the smallest table on the right side of the join. Hive caches the smaller table in memory and streaming this rule. So this is basically map set join. Okay, so though I think this particular mandatory, no, it is no more mandatory in the newer versions of Hive. Basically you can just keep the table at any side, whichever will be smallest and get will seem to be fitted into the map side task or map task, basically it will be taken. Okay, always try to create a partition on the table so that the queries do not search the whole table. This is what we have seen. So when we had a whole weather data for all year, okay, so we created a 12 partition, and when we ran for the January, it just gave us the result in 3 seconds, while it took to scan complete table for the same result in unpartitioned way around 40 seconds. Okay, so for 10 lakh of records, it saves us like almost 37 seconds. Okay, so you can just think of like billions of records or millions of, you know, records, it will definitely save us some good amount of time. If you feel that the dynamic partition will create a lot smaller partition, then you should use bucketing. Okay, so we also seen this. Suppose if the partition column that you have chosen, maybe it is having too many number of unique values. Okay, just like timestamp column. Okay, so if you create a partition on such field, basically it will create too many smaller partitions. Okay, so it will just, you know, flood the metadata also, and then in each partition there is very little data to work with, because every partition will be processed by a single map. Okay, so that map task will get very little data to process. So you are having plenty of maps running for that particular file, that particular table for all the partitions. And they are spending a lot of time, a lot of resources, but then doing nothing or doing very little. Okay, so always try to think in a way that you will get, you know, uniform data size for each map task, and it should be some enough so that, you know, complete resources that is available with map task will be utilized in order to do the calculation, to do the processing of your data. Okay, then only you will get faster results of your query. So this is again, this point is related to the skewness of the data that also we have seen. So yesterday when we, you know, put the data of weather in 12 partitions, so we have seen that all the partition have got like almost uniform distribution of data. So that kind of uniform distribution should always be there. Otherwise, what will happen is one map task gets very little data to process, another map task gets very large or very, you know, more very large set of data to be processed. So one map task finishes very early and another map task keeps, you know, taking a lot of time. Okay, because the earlier map task that finished very early, it did not utilize it, its resources properly, because there were a lot of resources available for that map task, but the data is so small that it finished very early. Okay, so ultimately it is adding the time for your overall job completion. So suppose if you uniformly distribute the data between two map tasks, basically they both finish very early, okay, because they are just paralleling. They don't hamper the processing of each other, because the two map tasks that we talk about is basically embarrassingly parallel process, because they never interact with each other. Simple. Okay, then if you go further, basically we need to talk about that what should be the format of the table that we are creating. So if you talk about Hortonworks, basically it is ORC Snappy. If you talk about Cloudera, it is basically Parquet file. Okay, Parquet file that you can create over there with the Snappy compression also is applicable in that. But Parquet is, takes some time it's not that beautiful like ORC, because it does not give you some statistics. Okay, ORC also has some statistics on the top of it. Okay, so due to that statistics, some kind of the min, max, average, count, these queries are much faster. Okay, when you talk about ORC file format. So we have seen that how to create ORC file format, put the Snappy compression on the top of it just by using table properties, and then compression is equal to Snappy. So Snappy is a non-splittable compression. It means that if you compress the whole file with Snappy, that file will process on single map, because that file cannot be splitted into the blocks and then get stored in the HDFS. So what needs to be done is basically first let the file split into the blocks, get them stored into the HDFS, and then apply the compression on the block level, so that the 128 MB of block may require only some 100 MB or 80 MB depending on the actual data inside it. Okay, so always go with this. If your table is ORC, then you can also use vectorization. So vectorization is a property, basically. If you make it on, what will happen is, instead of reading one row at a time, it will read 10,000 rows at a time and then get it into the cache and then do the calculations on that. So it will be faster. So it will reduce your hard disk IO, basically. Okay, so it will again add up, it will reduce the time of overall job completion. Okay, that is what is called vectorization. If you come down, then while joining two tables, basically you need to always use map site join. So by default it is on now, so there is no need to discuss on this, basically, but you just need to make sure that the map site join, that is Hive auto convert join, is true. Okay, if it is false, basically it will auto, because even if it is true, and if Hive sees that the two tables are very big enough that none of them can be easily fitted into the heap memory of map task, basically it will be automatically converted into reduced site join. Okay, so I think this point is not valid now, because it is by default in all the distributions of Cloudera and Hortonworks now onwards. Basically, you will get this property always remains true. Now, if you join tables bucketed, then you can use sort merge buckets map site join. Okay, so this sort merge bucket, so there is very strict check for this. What is that? Basically, if you are having two tables, okay, so they should first of all having the equal number of buckets. So suppose if there are 10 buckets in one table, there should be exactly 10 buckets on the second table. And then the join key on which you are trying to perform the join between two tables, those join key or the join column should be sorted in order, either ascending or descending, whatever. But in both the tables, it should be sorted in that order. Okay. And so it is very strict check. And then it will read one bucket from one table. So create a map task for that, and if it sees that that corresponding bucket from the second table can be easily fitted into the map task, it will just put it inside it. Okay, so again it would be set to be sort merge bucketed map site join. Okay, why it said sort merge? Because the column on which we need to perform join should be sorted in any order, either descending or ascending. Merge means we are actually merging the result in the join, and bucketed means both the tables are bucketed. Okay, it may, and there should be identical number of buckets in both the table, then only this will be performed, otherwise it would be normal join. That's it. Okay, so for this to have done, so you need to optimize map site bucket map site join should be true if you really want the map site join to happen for two buckets to be combined, and then sort merge true. Okay, so these two properties should be true. I think by default it is true, but whenever you try to perform this kind of operation, you need to make these two properties to be true. So So since the high does not support referential integrity, that what we have seen, okay, we can sometimes use a denormalization predictor to perform complex joins. Okay, so denormalization means have the redundancy in the data. Okay, don't make your join much complex. Otherwise, it is very difficult for Hive to optimize it. Okay, in denormalization, data is redundant, and due to replication, it will use more space. But that is okay because we have plenty of available space in HDFS. Even if we replicate it, no issues. But you can speed up the join with the with the denormalization of data. Okay, so these are some optimization. Furthermore, you can add 10, 20 more in it, but those are very, very specific to the scenarios in which you are working. Okay, so I think that's enough for what we need to discuss. Okay, few more points like cost-based optimization, try to compute statistics before you run the query. Okay, so that also some customization techniques only that you will add up in these points, whatever we have seen at the last. Okay, and you will come up around 30 to 50 optimization customization technique, have them understood, have them practiced well, and basically nobody can stop you in the Hive interview. Okay, so I think that's it from my side for today. Any questions?